everybody, I'm Kirsty Meekin from Naio Nails. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do some flat 3D art, but we're not going to use acrylic like we have in previous videos. This is going to be a little bit different, and we're going to use 3D sculpting gel. And we ain't going to use brushes. What we're going to use? My left toe. Joking, we're not.
We're trying the big one or the little one?
A little one, of course.
Oh, right, okay.
So I have a nail here. So I'm going to use this colour. It's Dionysus. So it's like a rouge noir. So a dark red. Burgundy, basically. You don't have to use this colour, obviously. I am showing you this more for the skill than anything else. But it is very nice. I'm going to do two coats of that colour. Now I'm going to apply the matte top coat. This is the Urban Graffiti matte top coat. Pop that in the lamp. Once that's cured, I'm going to use the gel residue wipe-off solution on a lint-free pad, and I'm going to wipe off the sticky layer. See, that takes the shine off the nail. That's perfect for painting on now. I'm going to use the 01 brush. I've got some white paint on here. This is actually still wet from yesterday. I haven't put on the greaseproof paper because I wasn't doing one stroke and I just wanted the paint on there. But the sponge is keeping the paint nice and wet. So there's the stem. I'm going to do another one here. And I'm going to do a few kind of like leaf lines coming off the stem. So I'm just pressing down and then pulling off to make it thinner. More pressure you put onto the brush, the thicker that will be. For composition, to make this flow, I'm just going to add a few lines up here as well. Now I'm going to use the matte top coat again. Seal that in. I want a generous amount, because I'm actually going to buff on top of that as well. So the only thing we're going to use the actual brush for is for the paint work, but to mould the 3D sculpted gel, we're not going to use a brush. I'm going to wipe that sticky layer off. What I'm going to do now is take a buffer. Now this is an old buffer. Old buffers are great for this because it's quite worn, and I'm just going to whip over the old nail to really make it matte. Extra matte. So let's clean it. And we have a nice matte nail. I can see a little bit of shine still there, so I'm just going to go over again. You'll only know if there's a bit of shine there by wiping it. So we'll wipe it again. So once you've cleaned that off and you're happy with how matte it is, now we're going to do the exciting part. Right, so I'm going to use, we have a new tool. This is the spatula. So it also comes with a case like that, so you can put the lid on it, which is pretty cool. Take it off. Have a nice spatula. So we're going to use this colour, which is the neon pink. I wanted a real contrast. Now, they definitely contrast, don't they? I'm going to use the spatula to scrape out what I need. And then we're going to use the silicone tools. Now, they all have different names because they all are different shapes. So we have a oval slant, we have a slant, we have a flat, we have a round slant, and then we have a round. So the first one I'm going to use is the flat one. Now in this little dampen dish I have here, I'm going to put a little bit of the gel residue wipe off solution. That's for cleaning my silicone tool. Now, silicone tools give a different effect than a brush. So what I'm going to do is, see how I just dipped the tool into the gel residue wipe off solution. I think you can kind of just smooth it like that, like you would do a cake. Yeah, icing a cake, and you can really smooth that out. So that gives quite a cool effect. So what I'm doing is I'm just placing that where I want it. I'm going to clean that tool off. Then I'm going to use my round tool. I'm going to go into the liquid again, tap off any excess. And then I'm going to start to press. You can press and slide. Now you can see why I use the colour underneath. This is what I wanted to get, this sort of graduation of colour, and literally just pressing into it and sliding to open out these petals. When it starts to stick to your tool, that's when you can add some more of the gel residue wipe off solution. Now I want to use the slant brush. It's not a brush! The slant tool now to come in the side, crisp up that part, and I want to crisp this part as well, so we just push that. Fantastic product this is, because you can just move it around until you are ready to cure. So this tool will keep everything nice and crisp, and I'm using the flat tool just to come in here. I want to press a little bit. I want to lift that. There. I need a round tool now, because I want to just give that a bit of a bend like this. This is the slant tool. I'm going to literally come in, crisp that edge up, and give it a slight curve to give movement. And I think I'm just going to add a little crease here. Oh yes, I like that. Right, I'm going to cure that. Before I cure it though, I want to make sure I've got any residue off the nail.
a little bit of a clean up, because that residue may cure on the nail. So let's give that a cure. So I'm going to take some more now. I'm going to use my spatula. Scrape off a little bit more. See, this isn't going to move now. I'm going to come here with it. You can pat it into place a little bit, but it'll want to stick to the metal tool a little bit more than it will a silicone tool. Going to use my flat tool, because I kind of want to spread it out. So I kind of spread it out evenly first. And then I'm going to use the round tool to start to press in. I'm coming along that crisp edge that we did on the previous petal. So you're still keeping that curve. The lighter the touch, the less transparent the product will go. So obviously, the more you press it, the thinner the product will be. So down here, I want it a bit thinner so I can see that other colour coming through, which creates the shading. Now I'm going to use the round slant, and I'm going to use this round part here just to smooth that. This one's the oval slant, and I'm just using this part here. Now I want to go back with this one, which is the slant. And I'm going to create a little bit more of a curve here. Just want to take any excess off there. I'm going to use the outer edge of the round slant, just come through here. So again, before I cure that, I'm going to make sure I've got no residue on the nail. And I'm going to pop that in and cure it. And then here, at the tip of this one, we're going to do like a little bud. So we only want a small amount. And I'm going to use the round tool again. And create a little opening, so the bud's just opening out. Literally just tapping it. The slant one, I'm just going to come through here. Just to really neaten that up, because it's got such a sharp point. The tool is really cool to just really neaten things up that I'm not, you know, they're not quite perfect. You know how fussy I am? There's the border that wasn't too difficult to do. And I'm going to cure that. Now I'm going to go back to the paint. I'm using a 00 brush now. And if you think, well, that doesn't look anything different than the other, well, it is. Can you see? That the 00 is smaller than the 01. So 002 is smaller than 01. The more zeros, the smaller it is. So a little bit of the white paint. Now this has a porous surface. So when we put the paint on, it will suck into it.
Does that mean there's no second chances?
Well, no, you can take it off. I'm just going to do some little lines to highlight. If you want to tidy any paint up, you can take your 3D brush, pop it into the gel residue wipe off solution, and use that to remove any paint that you don't want. Ryan Little. Don't like that bit, so I'm going to take that off. And what I'm going to do now is use the magenta paint. I'm going to add some lines with that. Just quite simple. And then I'm going to water this down. Shaded parts. Now because it's porous, it'll suck the paint in and you won't need to seal it.
And then we're gonna add a bit of bling.
So I've got the tiny iridescent stones. These have no backing and they are pointed. And then I've also got some green micro beads. I'm going to use a little bit of It's Clear Dear, which is the acrygel from the Urban Graffiti range. So I'm going to use my sexy spatula, scrape some off, and I'm just going to put on a little bit of this to the points of where I'm going to put the stones. 3D brush. It has a little bit of gel residue wiper solution on, just to neaten up the aqua gel. I'm going to pick up some of the stones, pop them on, press them. Don't need to press them too hard. Press them a little bit just so they sink into the gel. And then I'm going to get some of the beads. Add them. Keep everything nice and tidy. Now, if we were using acrylic to put these on, we wouldn't be able to keep moving them around like I am. So I do love this product for this reason. I'm going to pop that into the lamp. I'm going to take my 3D brush now with some of the gel residue wipe off solution on and just gently clean over the stones, just in case there's any residue there from the aqua gel. I love how it's matte. How it's matte. That is so stokey.
How it's matte.
How it's matte. I love how it's matte, Duck. I love how it's matte.
Like, how matte it is.
How matte it is. God, I'm so stokey. I'm such a stoke on Trent Bird. So not only is the background matte, but the actual flowers matte as well. I love it. I hope you like it too. There you are, guys. Hope you've enjoyed this video of how to create 3D flat nail art using the sculpture gel and the tools, the silicon tools. Because some people go, what are silicon tools for?
That's it.
There you are. That's how, for now. I've got to stop doing that.
Need to stop doing that.
I need to stop doing it.
We'll get sued.
I know,
copyright. By a television show that hasn't been around for 20 years.
Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell and check us out on Facebook and Instagram. And I'll see you guys in the next video. So please keep watching. Bye-bye. Right, now,